Hello friends, welcome to the channel. In this video, I plan to say today's cricket news. New Zealand 26 runs all out and other enduring records. On the 65th anniversary of the lowest innings score ever in Test cricket, we look at other major records that have stood for at least 50 years. On March 28, 1955, New Zealand were bundled out for a little over by England in Auckland. 65 years later, that is still the lowest total in Test cricket history. The closest any team has come to breaking that record was Ireland when they was bundled out for 38, also against England at Lord's this time last year. Here's a look at other major records in men's cricket that have survived for over a half century. Highest percentage of runs by a batsman in a completed test innings. In the first ever test in 1877, Charles Bannerman scored an unbeaten 165 out of Australia's 245, which is 67.34% contribution. Since then, the closest anyone has come to that mark is Michael Slater, who scored 66.84% of his team's runs, 123 of 184 balls in the New Year Test that is at SCG in 1999. Oldest to make the Test debut. One of the England players in that 1877 match above, England's James Southampton, was 49 years old and 119 days old when the test began. He remains the oldest debutant in the test cricket. Among the 15 oldest debutants on the list, only one started his test career after 1960, South Africa's Omar Henry, who debuted in 1992. Most runs in a test series. Among the many records by Don Bradman that haven't been broken yet in the one of the highest aggregate in the Test series, he accumulated 974 runs in the 1930 Ashes Australia vs England, in which he scored 4 centuries. 3 of those were double centuries, which is also a record for any series. The closest any batsman has come to this in the last 50 years was when Mark Taylor made 839 runs in the 1989 Ashes. Stephen Smith aggregated 750 plus runs in a series twice in the last decade. Best bowling figures in an innings and a match. Jim Lakers 10 for 53 in an innings and 19 for 90 in the match at Old Trafford against Australia in 1956 are still the best innings and match figures in Test cricket. Anil Kumble is the only other bowler to take Test take 10 in an innings, 10 for 74, but no bowler has matched Lakers 19 wickets in a match even in the first class cricket. Longest test career. Wilfred Rhodes played 58 tests in a 30-year-old long career between 1899 and 1930. He was 53 when he played his final test. In recent times, Sachin Tendulkar came closest to the mark when he retired in 2013 after a career of 24 years. Highest individual score and the best bowling figures on Test debut. Both these records are over 100 years old. Albert Trott picked up 8 for 43 on his debut in 1895, figures that haven't been bettered by a debutant. Through Bob Massey in 1972 and Narendra Hirwani in 1988 took 8 wickets in each innings on their debut. The highest individual score on Test debut is Tip Foster, 287, a record that has stood since 1903. Jacques Rodolphe came somewhat close with an unbeaten 222 on his debut in 2003. Most wickets in a test series. Sydney Barnes picked up 49 wickets in a 4-match test series against the Proteas South Africa in 1930-1914. Test series, which remains a record for the most wickets in a series. In the last 30 years, only one such bowler touched a 40 wicket mark in a series, Shane Warne in the 2005 Ashes. Most centuries in a test series. Clyde Walcott scored 5 centuries in the 5-match series against Australia in 1955. Several players have scored 400s in a series, including Virat Kohli and Stephen Smith in the recent years. Walcott also scored centuries in both innings of a match twice in that series, which is also unmatched by any other player yet. Youngest and oldest to take 5 wickets holds. A few months ago, Pakistan's 16-year-old sensation Nasim Shah picked up a 5-wicket haul against Sri Lanka. However, he missed being the youngest bowler to take 5 for by a few days. That record still belongs to his countryman Nasim Al Ghani from 1958. Meanwhile, in 1932, Australia's Bert Iron Mogul took 6 for 18 and 11 for 24 against South Africa at the age of 49, 311 days, making him the oldest to take 5 wicket haul and 10 plus wickets in a match. Biggest maiden test century score and the longest test innings. Gary Sobers converted his maiden century into triple and finished on a record unbeaten 365 against Pakistan in 1958. Since then, two batsmen have converted their maiden hundreds into triples, including the Karun Nair in 2016. But Sobers' innings remains the biggest maiden test hundred. Sobers also became the youngest to score a triple century and holds the record. Two hat-tricks in a test. Jimmy Matthews of Australia took 2 hat-tricks in the same test against South Africa at Old Trafford in 1912. No other bowler has achieved it since. Matthews picked up both those hat-tricks on the same day in different innings of the match. Thank you for watching my channel. Kindly like, subscribe and comment. And for more such notifications of the world cricket, kindly subscribe to the channel. And also, don't forget to click the bell icon. Thank you.